Tom Bird is a very talented artist, an artist to look out for. He's inspired by the landscape in Devon and Cornwall, and nature and its intricate elements. At the moment, Tom's work can be found at the gallery on the Ho, Plymouth. That's near West Ho, above El Cafe, and also in Mayflower Gallery, Plymouth Barbican. He's always looking for new galleries to show his work, possibly near the London area, so why not contact him?
Hey.
Hello, Tom. It's the 16th of February.
Yes, it is.
2015. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm pretty good today. Yeah.
So I've just been taking a look at this painting. What's it called?
It's called Mystery of Mount Edgecombe.
Yeah.
And it's inspired by many walks I've done at Mount Edgecombe. Beautiful place, you know, in the evenings, the sky just changes colour in so many beautiful ways. And basically, this painting here, when I was, the evening that inspired me for this picture, the cloud actually kind of did a similar movement to this and followed an S shape with the rip current, when the rip currents create pathways out to sea that a little bit more reflective than the wind blowing the sea. It just created this perfect S, and I tried as hard as I could to recreate that. It's not, that's actually not as perfect as the real life thing was, and it was just mind-blowing, you know.
So you've got so much detail in your work. How did you find your style? Because it's so different to anybody else's.
Yeah, well, like, when I'm painting, I like to escape into the image, you know, escape into the, almost creating another little world.
Yeah.
Another little environment, atmosphere almost, you know, on the canvas.
Escapism.
Escapism, really. And it's the therapy, you know, it's the therapy. And, it just makes you admire the detail that's all around us in nature, you know, like, it's everywhere. And
you were on about how you develop the intricate style by being out in nature. Can you?
It makes you realise the intricacy of nature, really, doesn't it? I think seeing it through the eyes of, like, if you've been painting this stuff and then you go out for a walk in nature and then you go by the sea, or then you go out into the woods, you are kind of admiring in so much more depth the detail there. And it's just mind-blowing, really, when you really look into everything. I mean, you know, you've got the trees, then you've got the leaves, and then you go into the leaves, and there's even more detail. It's just unbelievable.
Yeah.
Being able to escape into the image.
Yeah, artists learn to see with open eyes, helps. Where a lot of people are blind to what's going on around them.
Mm.
I mean, walking around.
Well, that's it, you know.
And the more you see, the more you see into it.
That's right.
And which is what you've got brilliantly in your work.
Thanks. Yeah, I mean, I like people to be able to zoom in into another world, you know. And if other people can escape into my work as much as I did when I was doing it.
I've never seen anybody do work in your sort of style, so how did you develop your style?
It started off when I was younger. I was at the beach a lot, and just seeing how the waves and the clouds moved, and I decided that creating line work,
yes,
for a start, like doing this fine lines, really allowed me to express on an image, on a canvas, like the different directions and movements and flows of the water when it's moving like it is. And then I refined that into, I guess, it kind of transferred into doing the detail here.
So this is Mount Edgecombe in early 2015, isn't it? One of your walks.
Yeah, it was one of the walks I think it was actually...
Just before Christmas.
Just before New Year, actually, between Christmas and New Year.
Yeah, that's only about a mile and a half from here.
Yeah, it's just over the river. You can get a ferry there. It's beautiful, like a little foot ferry. It's such an experience. You can even see it out the window, yeah.
There's my Tesco.
That's it, yeah. Yeah. And it's, so it's actually, it's kind of a mix of two images of Mount Edgecombe.
Yeah.
Kind of put into one. So
I think we saw it unfinished before. Oh, no, we didn't video it, but I talked to you whilst you... Have you got the image here? No, you haven't.
Oh, no, I haven't. No, I haven't got the pictures. Yeah. But even so, I mean, that wooded area there, you can walk through that and the sea is still just there. But I just decided to incorporate a cliff that's around that area too in there.
Well, these areas are eroding very quickly, and a lot of the areas, when I first came to Plymouth, a lot of these sort of coastal paths around Mount Edgecombe are in the sea now.
Yeah, so I know, especially since that storm of winter 2014, wasn't it?
Yeah, this time last year.
This time last year, yeah.
Valentine's Day 2014.
Yeah, those storms really did annihilate the place.
Yeah, and